Following program is a production of AGW Entertainment, heard on the official website of AGW Entertainment. It's that time once again for AGW Entertainment Radio.
And that's all I got to say about that.
Hosted by Jonathan Clark.
Gotta be the man!
You gotta be the man!
Whoa!
Be sure to join us in the live chat room during the show.
Hulkamania is running wild like it's never ran before.
Call us on one of our request lines. If you live in the United States, call us at 1-641-985-7800, box number 372928. If you're from Canada and would like to call us from 1-647-724-4194, box number 372928. Long-distance charges may apply in some areas.
I've been the World Heavyweight Champion 10 times.
Or you can always drop us a line at MySpace, myspace.com/AGW Entertainment.
And you will rest in peace.
Emailing us works for you too. Email us AGWWrestling@hotmail.com.
I am a wrestling god. J.B.L. J.B.L.
And now, without any further ado, here is your host of AGW Entertainment Radio, on the official website of AGW Entertainment, Jonathan Clark.
The champ is here!
Date?
Oh, yeah.
Excuse me a second. Yes! My six-month plan worked!
Come to think of it, I had a six-month plan, too. Interview everybody there was to interview on the internet, get a job with WWE or TNA, and then become the most famous personality in all of professional wrestling. But it never turned out that way. Funny how life works, isn't it? I'm still interviewing people and still struggling my way to 1,000. But once I hit that, there's only one thing left to do. Retire.
colliding. Comes a memory that lasts. Not a word is left unspoken as the thunder starts to crash. Maybe I should give.
Jonathan Clark saying, "Hey ho, let's go," the opening lyrics to the theme of Sweet Life on Deck, which celebrated its final episode just several weeks ago on Disney Channel. Are you upset that Sweet Life on Deck and Cole and Dylan Spratton are parting ways with the Disney company after what felt like forever with them being involved with the show Sweet Life of Zack and Cody and then being revamped into the Sweet Life on Deck? It seemed like they were there forever. It seemed like a lot of the original Disney stars were there forever, and when I saw the final episode of Sweet Life on Deck, I was like, okay, where are these guys going to go now? Where are they heading now? Are they coming back on a new series? Are they going to part ways and do something different? Because they were great together on Disney, didn't you think? Let us know at Facebook.com, Jonathan Clark, and YouTube.com, Jonathan Clark 22, how you felt about Sweet Life on Deck coming to an end. The cast of Sweet Life on Deck parting ways with the show. They graduate from school, the boat docks, they part ways, they have an emotional scene where everybody cries, and they leave the fans, the audience, wondering what's next for Cole and Dylan Spratton. I remember watching the original Sweet Life of Zack and Cody, originally starring Brenda Song and Ashley Tisdale, who was great on Sweet Life on Deck, a young girl coming a long way from doing JCPenney commercials when she was about 8 or 9 years old, and then starring on Sweet Life of Zack and Cody, the show in my mind that gave Ashley Tisdale a big break. She later go on to star in 3 installments of High School Musical. She'd later go on to star in such productions as Aliens in the Attic, Sharpay's Fabulous Adventure, a follow-up to High School Musical, and that very unique role she played in that. She's a voice of Candace on Phineas and Ferb. So in my opinion, I think that Sweet Life of Zack and Cody definitely paved the road for her career. She made the decision to leave the show Sweet Life of Zack and Cody when the show was revamped to Sweet Life on Deck. She agreed to make several appearances guest starring on the Sweet Life on Deck, which she did as her original character, Natty. It's kind of sad, you know, to know that the Sweet Life of Zack and Cody is over. I enjoyed it. I thought that was a great show. I remember when the show used to be on every Friday. The whole week you'd be wondering what's next for the cast of Sweet Love of Zack and Cody back when it was originally known as the Sweet Love of Zack and Cody, and it was on Friday nights as part of a block of television on Disney Channel. It's kind of sad because now we're wondering where, you know, the cast is heading. Obviously, Brenda Song is going to land some movie deals. I think she's going to head down the same road as Vanessa Hutchins, who just recently starred in Beastly. She was just in Social Network, Brenda Song. Well, she didn't have a big role in the Social Network movie, which was a movie that talked about Facebook. Facebook.com, Jonathan Clark, by the way. It was a movie that centered, the focal point of it was about Facebook and what kind of trouble you can get yourself in if you make a Facebook account and misuse and abuse the service. Social Network starred a number of great talents. Brenda Song was one of them. Now with Sweet Life on Deck taking a back seat on Disney Channel, I guess that will open up more doors for her to star in more films with more mature themes, and I'm going to be looking forward to seeing what they're going to be doing with her. Debbie Ryan, I don't know so much about. She first premiered on Sweet Life on Deck. Of course, she was the replacement for Ashley Tisdale, in my mind, after Ashley Tisdale parted ways with the original Sweet Life of Zack and Cody. The mother who played the mother of Colin Dillon Spratton on the show parted ways with the program. She wasn't a part of Sweet Life on Deck. She was a part of the premiere, the launch of the series, where she parted ways with her sons, and then she never came back on after. So they did lose a lot of the talent from the original series when the show was revamped. And now it seems like there's going to be nothing for Debbie Ryan to do unless she comes back on her own show or Brenda Song comes back on her own show on Disney Channel. I think that a lot of Disney stars after Hannah Montana finished up back in 2010, the summer of 2010, with Hannah Montana Forever being the final season after 6 years of Hannah Montana, I think that a lot of the Disney stars wanted to part ways with Disney to go on to do something else.